Hi! In my previous video, I showed some optical properties of 24 different glass mixes. Some will change color with normal light, others will change color and fluoresce beautifully with ultraviolet light. This time I will test their magnetic properties and include two extra samples. We don't think of glass as being magnetic, but maybe it can be. Big neodymium magnets will bite you beyond repair. Do not handle unless you are aware of and accept all risks involved. First things first, let's test the optical properties of the extra samples I didn't include in the previous video, uranium and gadolinium glass. With normal light bulbs, I don't see a change in color in the new samples. Their color tone does change with the light source, but not as much as the first three. They have completely different colors depending on the light source. But one of the new samples does have a trick with the right light. Ultraviolet light. Now the uranium ions fluoresce with a beautiful deep green color. The gadolinium glass bead still doesn't do anything, but it may shine later. Uranium glass is amazing. I have a collection of it since it combines my fascination of radioactivity and fluorescence in one. What more can I ask for? Maybe if it could be magnetic too. Time to test the glass beads near a magnet. This will not be a test of the magnetic properties of the metals in the glass, since these beads are mostly made of glass. For the pure elements, you should watch my video series Exotic Elements vs. Magnets, where I also explain the different magnetic orders in part 4. But take a guess, which of these beads will be attracted the most by a magnet? And how many will even be lifted by a magnet? My first test is an easy one that will show if they are attracted to or repelled by a magnet. I will use a 50mm sphere magnet, which has an intense, concentrated magnetic field on the poles. Strong enough to make a flame dance, as shown earlier. With the beads floating on water, even the slightest magnetic force in the beads can be detected with this magnet. First, some control tests. The styrofoam boat in itself is almost neutral. Looks like it is slightly repelled by the magnet. Plain glass is clearly repelled. It is, in technical terms, diamagnetic. Will most glass beads be repelled then, even with tiny amounts of metal dopants in them? Let's find out. Alright, I was surprised that 4 beads are attracted enough to be lifted, and not even the ones with the ferromagnetic metals, iron, cobalt and nickel. I did not guess right, did you? If we look closer, there does seem to be some link between the metal in the glass bead and the magnetic reaction. The attracted glass beads all contain a ferro or paramagnetic metal, while the repelled glass beads contain the diamagnetic or weakly paramagnetic metals. We still need to measure which one is attracted the most. For this, I'll use an old favorite of mine, the water bath run. The more attracted, the faster the time. The slowest with the least attraction are really slow, but let's get it over with. Now, the final four are of course the ones that got lifted. Here's the battle for bronze. Holmium just takes it by a fifth of a second. And now for the winner. Finally, the gadolinium glass bead shines. Did you guess right? I am surprised that four rare earth metals top the leaderboard. Except iron, the ferromagnetic metals are almost the worst performing. But looking at the label for the cerium glass bead, you may find a clue. It contains gadolinium like the winning bead. Gadolinium has some interesting magnetic properties since it can be ferromagnetic at normal temperatures. I tried testing if the gadolinium bead is ferromagnetic. If it can have a magnetic field in itself, like a magnet, it is ferromagnetic. But I did not see any magnetic field coming from it, so it is likely just strongly paramagnetic. I asked the seller if these four beads all contain gadolinium. I did get a lot of interesting details showing how complicated it is to perfect these glass beads. But I never got a clear answer on the exact content. I guess it is a trade secret. I understand. Still, I wouldn't be surprised if they all contain gadolinium based on their strong magnetic reaction. The final step is to correct for the weight of the beads. They range from 0.8 to 1.8 grams. Based on the experimental data from one of my previous videos, heavier beads are faster. I did not figure out why in the video, at all, but based on your feedback, there seems to be two major factors. The weight of the boat is only 80 milligrams, but it can't be ignored. For a 1 gram bead, the boat is an extra 8% weight, while it is only half as much for a 2 gram bead. Heavier beads therefore have a better force per weight ratio with the same boat. The boat does sink lower with a heavier bead, causing more water drag. But the boat area in contact with water is only 22% more for a twice as heavy bead, again favoring the heavier beads with a better force to water drag ratio. In such an apparently simple setup, it still boggles my mind how difficult it is to estimate the time differences for different bead weights. Any input in the comment section is appreciated. Anyway, based on my experimental data, this is my best guess at the weight corrected times. Luckily for me, it doesn't really change much, so the conclusion stays the same. Thanks to all my patrons. Creators like me aren't always praised here on the internet, but at least I have your fantastic support. Thank you very much.
Cut chrome. Chromium. Nej.
Click like if you don't dislike what I do, and thank you very much for watching. Bye for now.